Constantino.
¡Qué vale!
Pound for pound.
Robert, and as far as Lomachenko, you know, he's been off the rank since that Teofimo fight. Who would you like to see him fight next?
Well, I don't know why. Well, you know, boxing, as you see it, it's a tough sport, you know. One day you're on top of the world, pound for pound, the best fighter in the world, and then you lose a fight, and nobody talks about you, nobody mentions you, you know. That happened to Lomachenko, you know he was pound for pound, the best fighter in the world, and everybody was comparing him to the greats in the sport. Some said he was even better than Mayweather. Some said he was better than Muhammad Ali. Stuff like that, you know. And then his performance against Teofimo, which was actually a very close fight, they just pretty much
wrote him off
and stopped talking about him. I think Lomachenko's a great fighter. I think I honestly think that in a rematch, I think Lomachenko beats Teofimo. He started, I don't know why, he started too late. I don't know why he gave away the first six rounds. Honestly, I have no idea. But you know, after that, when he started picking it up, I think he had some solid rounds. I think some of those rounds that he won were much better than all the rounds, the first six rounds that Teofimo won. Teofimo won those rounds not because he put a beating on Loma. I think Teofimo won those rounds because Loma didn't do nothing. Loma was just too cautious, backing up, you know, didn't let his hands go. If that was a game plan, well, they made a, you know, it was really a bad game plan. I don't think they thought they could knock him out that easy. But there was a time, I don't remember which round, but late in the fight where he was actually landing some solid punches. So if he starts a little bit sooner, I think he could even beat Teofimo in a rematch. Not saying Teofimo doesn't have a chance. Obviously, Teofimo could beat him again, but I'm thinking he does have a chance of beating him if they do a rematch. I think he's up there with anybody at lightweight. I think he could still beat Devin Haney. He could still beat the Ryan Garcia. I think he could a really good fight where it would probably be a 50-50 would be him against Tank. Tank is also, you know, very explosive, very powerful. But I don't know. I would probably pick Loma over Tank.
Is that a viable, like a foreseeable fight, you think, him and his comeback? Maybe not Tank, but maybe like somewhere around there.
Well, I don't think so, especially being that they fight for different promotions, you know. I don't think that's even a reality fight anytime soon. But from what I've heard, is he's coming back against the Japanese guy, you know, from what I've heard. There was also talk about him against Valdez, so I don't know. If he decides to fight at 135, there's still a lot of fights out there. I think he could still become a world champion without a problem. I think if he comes down to 130, because I've also heard that, I think he could dominate at 130 and be the best at that division. You know, he's a great fighter, very talented, very skillful. You know, he just had one bad night, and you know, he made a mistake. He started too late. The game plan they had didn't work. You know, it happens, you know. It's just the way boxing is. You know, you just one day you're just not at your best and you lose a fight. That doesn't mean you don't have what it takes to come back and become a world champion again. I think Loma does have what it takes.
Constantino Garcia here for Little Giant Boxing. Make sure you guys subscribe and follow me on social media at Constantino Garcia.